learning environments. This is the last thing, and then I will introduce another break, just to make you still awake for a second or what. So, these are the two different learning environments. So, I'm quickly showing you, and I'm telling you the first one, I cannot actually show. I mean, Teresa did a real good job, but you should have a laptop to go, and some of you have your laptop, so you could actually now go here, because if I do it here, then the screen is too small, and this doesn't work. This is something about cascading style sheets that I don't like. So, if I go here, it opens up at least. Now, so this is the task analysis website, it's Teresa's. So, this is the home, but it's kind of spoiled at the moment. I'm sorry about this. But if you put it on your laptop and you take a full screen mode, you're fine. Yeah?
Yeah.
It should work on a full screen mode. Now, here it doesn't, this is rubbish. Now it's I hate it. We are working on it, but the screen is too small, right? Anyhow, I could put here design for task, then I have an introduction, then I have an example, which is a real life example that you could scroll. This is a very big example, this is nice. Then you have something about analysis, you have something about envisioning, you have something about detailed specifications, and something about assessment. So this is my whole story, right? It's all here. And then you have task concepts, so this is about tasks, agents, roles, objects, event. And then we have the problems, references, the ontology, is in a way it's nice. Teresa did a good job here. So, I'm not sure where this works, let me find out.
So in order to understand the relation between the different concepts, like the concept of roles and objects and tasks, we need an ontology, and in this case the ontology starts with tasks. One of the interesting things is that each task in fact has a goal. You could even consider the definition of the task an activity that has a goal. So this is a very important relation. Now there could be more than one task. There are related tasks.
Never stop talking about it. Anyhow, there's another thing that I forgot to put here. So, those of you who have a full screen, there's to the right, there's a tab, which is labeled?
Fine Techniques.
Fine Techniques, which you should put your head about.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, just because I don't know by heart. Next to one, so what's the URL here? Visit. So I will show it here, because this is because the screen is too small, but on your machine it works fine. Okay, the thing is not okay, so in Wizard, no, it doesn't work. Let me tell you what the wizard does. The wizard allows you to answer questions, and based on the questions, you get different techniques. So there's distributed cognition, ethnography, hermeneutics, interview, and so you can go to interview, for instance. I think that should still work. I have the goal for the interview. You can find out what's the problem. Well, this is why we should do an interview. This is how we should do it. This is examples. Organize a meeting. So this is the example of the interview. And I scrolled right. No. Once again, this is an example. This is probably and here's where you can find more information. So this is Suzanne Sebillon's original paper. So for each of these techniques, you can find it. And the techniques are written. I have to look at one of your screens if you don't mind. Because my machine is crazy because of the spot is small. Can I use this one?
Yeah.
So if you would go there, those of you you can look at task knowledge. If you look at task knowledge, you can answer the question, where is the knowledge? The knowledge could be in a person or it could be in the group and the context. Like this knowledge on the walls and the doors is in the context. Knowledge that you know or you are able to do is in the group. So you can choose one of these, And independent of that, you could say, is it explicit or implicit? Now, you already know this. This is exactly the four quadrants of the Jordan. And depending on what you choose, you get suggestion of techniques to apply. And if you don't like one of these choices, you can actually remove it. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then the second thing is about focus. Focus could be on actors or roles or on the process. Mm-hmm. Focus could be on action or on experience. You know about experience, do you?
Yeah.
It's the main buzzword on our domain, right? Mm-hmm. And you could focus on objects or context and group. And for each of them, you can make a choice or no choice. You can make a choice and then take it away. You see what happens. Every time you change something, you find out that the system tells you that it's... What's going on? If I change this, you should be able to see that things change. Okay.
Yeah.
Normally that should be some kind of nice animation, but for some reason it's covered. Okay, and then we have design phases. You can decide you are talking about the task analysis, about task design, about dialogue design, or about assessment. So in a way, this and Teresa built this this relation between techniques and tools and different questions just last week. So I'm really happy with the work she did. And so consequently, based on what you would like to find out, you get a suggestion of techniques and tools. And each technique of tool you can take or not, but you can have a look at it. You get the how, the why, examples, pointers, references. And so I'm not going to discuss all of them, but I would really like each of you, during the rest of the week, each time there is the next step in the task analysis and design, I would like for each group, each of the members of the team to take one or two techniques that they used and show me why they used them and how they used them. Right? So, in other words, I would like you to teach each other how to use these tools and techniques. And please don't use the examples that I put in here, but use your own examples from your client. So to show that, well, I choose this because, and even if it fails, you can show how it fails, right? But this is the way we understand it, if you really do it yourself. And if you do it yourself, you teach each other. So starting tomorrow, I'm expecting not just to tell them, this is what we found, but we use this technique, look here. And each of you can use a separate technique. So in a group, you make choices. There are about 40 techniques here, and I would be ever so happy if some of you at least looked at most, at one of them, and we will maybe have already a presentation of 30 of the techniques in total. Yeah? I play around with the tool. This tool is there for finding out what could be possible. It's not prescribing, it's not a prescription tool. It's showing possibilities. If you are looking not so much at objects but at the context, then maybe you should consider these tools. So take some tools, find out whether they work or not, and show us what you find. Okay? I think that's the best way to learn. And I'm not going to assign techniques or tools to you. In some cases, in some cultures I do, but I think it's not needed. But I think that's the best way to learn. Yeah? What's possible, right? Okay, so this is one thing that I will now try to shut down. And there's the other one, the close steps, yeah, sure. And then there's the other one. So this is another website, and here you need to log in. Now, happily, I've been here before, so she knows me. And now I'm going to the task analysis. You will only be able to go to task analysis. And you find some funny things, and here it says participants. And so in the course of the afternoon, the participants will be there. If not already, no, you can see this is just a test. But they will be there, will be you. And then you have an overview, and you have an introduction. And there will be my PowerPoints and the videos. And for each of this will be, so analysis will be filled tomorrow. So, and visioning will be filled on Wednesday. Assessment will be filled on Thursday, coming soon. And on Friday there will be reports and presentations. And now there is even already a discussion of one of the clients. because Teresa knows, she puts everything she knows already in the website. Yeah? Okay, good. So this website is only for you, so this is why you need to log in, right? And you will get to log in and you will know nobody else will log in. Yeah. Okay. These are the four clients, or the four projects. So this project is in Hundo.
We know the company.
Sorry?
We know the company.
You know the company?
Yeah.
And the lady I talked to was a student herself here.
Yeah.
She took the course last year.
Yeah.
Yeah, we know.
Okay, good. So I think this would be very helpful, but it's kind of far away. And I think to start with, some of you have to go there. Some meaning maybe two people. And the others could work through Skype. But Leah told me, I'm not sure I should say this, but that there would be a possibility to rent a car if somebody could drive a car. So, what else? Okay, so this is one. And this is another. and this is apparently very close to here, Tilburg. Yeah, I don't know. So anyhow, so this is David has been working on things and he I talked to him as well. He's very happy to collaborate and so he wouldn't be in any way shocked if you would bother him every day. He really likes to have some kind of task analysis here. And then later on he came up with another one, which is this one. I kind of lost, oh, here it is. So, this is also, he would like to have an app for the municipality of Tilburg. I think this could be challenging as well. And then he is mentioning another company that's apparently kind of his neighbor or something like that. These people also would benefit, according to David, from a task analysis. So, as far as I can see, I couldn't find Mia in the break, but my suggestion would be, but she should agree, I think, because I'm not the boss of this, but I suggest there could be four different designs, four different kind of task analysis. And that would make sense that we would have like four people for each. So the most travel-minded people should go to a Hundo, and the others should just restrict themselves to Tilburg. Tilburg, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. So, and Laura is online. Whatever. So, these are the clients, and I think I'm finished now. But if you want, you can step through this in the next 15 minutes. Is that okay? In a way, what I would like to do is I would like to set up some kind of a social event in forming teams and choosing a client. From my point of view, about four people in the team would be really good. And I think all four of these clients make a lot of sense. Or two are the same, David, but apparently he is willing to spend a lot of his time on this. He's really eager. So, that's fine. You know him, maybe?
Somebody knows him.
Somebody.
Okay. So, whatever.
Really well.
I'm going for a coffee, and I leave this to you, right?
Okay.
And in 15 minutes, there will be maybe some kind of tentative structure, yeah?
Yeah.
Because you need to be able to do things, and this is what is possible is to do things. So I will leave it here, and you can step through it.
Yes, okay.
Because it's not yet in the website for now, but it's here, so you can just step to my PowerPoint.
Yeah, maybe you have to share it like a USB stick, so we can.
Oh, that's fine with me. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I will just. Bluntly put the whole PowerPoint, and these are the last four or five slides.
Okay.
Yeah, and then you can publish it in this community. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Should I turn off the video?
Yeah, I think so.